गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन माई लास्ट क्लास आई इंट्रोड्यूस्ड यू टू पारो आनंद द ऑथर ऑफ सुवीरा एंड देन वी बिगैन विद द क्लास विद द लेसन सुवीरा वेर इन यू हैड सीन द ऑथर. दिस इज फर्स्ट पर्सन नरेशन. द लेसन इज इन फर्स्ट पर्सन नरेशन एंड द ऑथर इज स्पीकिंग ओवर हियर. शी सेज दैट इन बिटवीन इन द मिडल ऑफ द टर्म शी जॉइंड अ न्यू स्कूल बिकॉज ऑफ हर फादर्स जॉब. फादर शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम वन जॉब एंड ही वॉन्टेड टू join something else, right? And that's why they shifted from Calcutta to Delhi. So this is what we had seen, and this shifting brought a lot of change in their life. They had to face many difficulties because from a comfortable zone or from a luxurious lifestyle, they had to come to a place wherein it was not at all a comfortable area for them. Or was not at all luxurious for them, and they had to adjust, hoping that they are going to make the best out of it and they are going to have a better time over there. They are starting their life. So all these things, how they are planning to begin with all this stuff we had seen. So it was the second day for the little girl in the school. When she went to the school, she happened to see that all were practicing. They were in trials for the inter-school athletic meet. And so she saw all the other students of the school were very busy. And every house, like how we have the houses, red house, yellow house, blue house, the green house. Like that, every house had their favorites and they were all after their favorites. All the students were much more concentrating on their favorite participants of each of the events. Packets of glucose, everything was all set and ready. Everything was set and kept ready for the inter-school athletic meet. So all these things we had seen in our previous class. Let us begin from this particular paragraph. I sat near the track, shaking my legs to keep off the mid-January chill. And also I guess the nervousness. I had come from Calcutta with its warmer climate and was unprepared for the sting of Delhi's chilly winter mornings. I wore a red t-shirt and white shorts. Red because I was put into the red house. But my housemates pretty much ignored me. Not that they were being unfriendly on purpose, just that it was a busy day. A day to back the favorite, not some unknown. I also cursed myself for being stupid enough to volunteer to run the 800 meters race. Deepthi told me that I had an impossibly tough race ahead. So you can see I sat near the track shaking my legs. You can see the little girl sitting near the track. Track you might have seen in the school during the sports, on the sports day, especially on sports day, you might have seen the white lines drawn, right? So that is what is called as a track. So here she sat very near to the track shaking my legs, and she was shaking her legs to keep off. To keep off in the sense to avoid. To avoid what? The mid-January chill. So it was the middle of January and it was very cold. You know, it's very cold in Delhi in January. So that is what is being told over here. And she was just trying to avoid the cold, what she was feeling. She was feeling very cold at that point, and that she was trying to avoid. And at the same time it is mentioned over here. And also I guess the nervousness. So at the same time she was feeling nervous over here. So when we are nervous, we keep on shaking our legs, isn't it? So something or the other thing, each one of you might be having a different habit of nervousness, isn't it? Something or the other thing you keep on doing when you are nervous. So this is what had happened over here. The girl was very nervous, so maybe because of that she was shaking her legs, right? I had come from Calcutta with its warmer climate and was unprepared for the sting of Delhi's chilly winter mornings. So she came from which place? Calcutta. Calcutta, the capital of West Bengal. Kolkata, the so-called Kolkata. She came from Calcutta with its warmer climate. So Calcutta in January, what is the climate of Calcutta? It's warm, right? And was unprepared for the sting. And she was not prepared. Unprepared in the sense, why she was not prepared? In the sense, she might have not carried her woolen clothes. When it is too cold, when it is very cold, we use woolen clothes to protect ourselves from the cold. So over here, she might have not carried her woolen clothes. That is why she has mentioned over here and was unprepared for the sting. The sting is the sting of the cold, the sting of the cold. The meaning is given at the bottom over here. Sharp tingling pain or sensation. So here the sharp pain, no, this is the sharp sting of the cold. When it is extremely cold, you won't be able to bear it, is it right? So that sensation, that feeling of the cold, of Delhi's chilly winter morning, cold winter mornings, right? So it was extremely cold in Delhi in the mornings, especially in the mornings. So what was she wearing? She was wearing, I wore a red t-shirt and white shorts. Red because I was put into the red house. See here everywhere it's mentioned like I wore, isn't it? I was put. So this mentioning of I and speaking in terms of it is called as the first person narration. I hope you know that. So I wore a red t-shirt. So this girl is saying, now this I, whom is that I referring to? The narrator. So narrator is speaking to us, isn't it? So I is the narrator. I wore a red t-shirt and white shorts. So what was she wearing? A red t-shirt and she was wearing white shorts. So with that you can understand how cold it will be for her, how much she might be suffering in that cold weather. Red because I was put into the red house. She was wearing that red because she was in red house. They had given her the house, this particular house, red house. But my housemates pretty much ignored me. But her housemates, those other students who belong to her house, that is the red house, just ignored her. Why did they ignore her? They ignored her because they were not knowing her. They were not knowing her talent. They were not knowing this little girl and they were not knowing her talent because she was new to them. She was a new student in their school and they were not knowing that whether she was good in athletics or no. That was not known to the other students. Not that they were being unfriendly on purpose, just that it was a busy day. So they didn't do it purposely because that was natural thing, isn't it? They will only support whom they know, whom they felt like they were talented in certain events and they were capable to do certain in certain activities. They could participate and they could fulfill it. So they would definitely appreciate them or support them, right? So that is what you can see. Not that they were being unfriendly on purpose, just that it was a busy day. It was a busy day for them. It was total busy day for them. They never ignored her. They gave much attention to her. They were friendly children. So that is what is being told away. They were not unfriendly, right? But they were knowing only few whom they knew right from their childhood who were good in sports. That is why they might have gone after them without bothering the new student because they were not knowing the new student's talent. A day to back the favorite, not some unknown. So that was a day for them to cheer their favorite, to cheer their heroes of the school, isn't it? The one who were talented in participating in all these events, whatever were held over there. So those who were talented, they were after them, cheering them. They were busy after those children and they just ignored this particular girl. I also cursed myself for being stupid enough to volunteer to run the 800 meters race. So this girl is saying, even I just felt that it was my stupidity that I went and joined the 800 meters race without knowing anything, just enough to volunteer. Simply I went to volunteer to run the 800 meters race. This is what she says. Deepthi told me that I had an impossibly tough race ahead. So Deepthi is another classmate of hers or a schoolmate of hers of the new girls. And she told narrator. She told her that I had an impossibly tough race ahead. So she warned her that she's going to have, that is the narrator is going to have a tough time in participating the 800 meters race because the other one who's going to participate along with her is a very good competitor. This is what Deepthi warned her, Deepthi informed her earlier. Now, who's the other one? Let us see in the next paragraph. That is what we are going to see. And the main protagonist of our story is Suvira. So, that is what we are now introduced to, the main protagonist of the story, Suvira Mathur. So, Suvira Mathur of Blue House has never been beaten in this event, not even at the inter-school events. In fact, She assured me Suvira holds the Delhi inter-school record for 800 meters. So this is what is being told. Suvira Mathur. So there was a girl called as Suvira Mathur in the same school of Blue House, and she was from the Blue House. Where is the narrator is from which house? Narrator is from Red House. So Suvira Mathur belonged to Blue House. Has never been beaten in this event. Was never defeated in this event. Which event? 800 meters race. 800 meters race. She was never defeated, Suvira Mathur. Not even at the inter-school events. So never she was beaten in the event. Not even for the inter-school events. So whenever she participated in the inter-school events, there also she always won 800 meters race. In fact, she assured me, not only that, but she told, who? Deepthi told narrator that Suvira holds the Delhi inter-school record for 800 meters. So she was the record holder of Delhi inter-school record. She was a record holder of Delhi inter-school for 800 meters. So she, with that you can understand, she was a winner, isn't it? Record holder means she always won the 800 meters and nobody was there to defeat her as such. So that is why Deepthi told her that she was a very good competitor, and the narrator is going to have a tough time participating or competing with this girl, Suvira Mathur. Let us move to the next part of the text. And see in the picture, now you can see in the picture as well over here, Suvira Mathur standing in blue, right? And the narrator is sitting near the track in red t-shirt, right? So you might have seen the picture of both Suvira and the narrator. Let us concentrate on the text now, the paragraph. I eyed the said Miss Mathur. She had long muscular legs and a true runner's easy stride. She had a friendly face which flashed smiles to everyone, dressed in a blue t-shirt. But when she moved, she was like well-oiled machinery. I tried to shake off my feeling of certain disaster. I had to make a decent go of this. Now that I put myself into this, I may as well give it my best shot. I had won the 800 meters a couple of times in Calcutta. What was the guarantee that Suvira was better and faster than me? Who knows, I could well turn out to be the new heroine of the school, queen of the fast track or something grand like that. So all these things mentioned over here are the imagination of the narrator. I eyed the said Miss Mathur. So she just looked at the said Mathur, this girl, Suvira Mathur. She had long muscular legs. So long legs, which were muscular ones, right? You can see. And true runner's easy stride. And she had a true runner's. So in her walk, she seemed to be a true runner for the narrator. She had a friendly face which flashed smiles to everyone dressed in blue t-shirt. So she was giving very friendly smile. She was having a friendly face. This is what the narrator says. Which flashed smiles. So she smiled at everyone. To everyone dressed in a blue t-shirt. So she was smiling at all the team members of her house. Blue house, right? So those who were in blue t-shirt, she was smiling at them. But when she moved, she was like well-oiled machinery. So what do you understand by this? Whenever she moved, she was like well-oiled machinery. Very flexible, right? Very flexible in her movement. Machineries are like that, isn't it? When you oil them, they are very easy to move. So same was the girl, was easily moving. So her movements were very flexible. So I tried to shake off my feeling of certain disaster. So the narrator was afraid, was scared. Facing her, isn't it? So facing this particular challenge, I tried to shake off my feeling of certain disaster. So she was afraid of the disaster. Now what is the disaster? To compete with Suvira Mathur. So that was a disaster for her. So I tried to shake off my feeling. So she was just trying to convince her. She was just trying to put her up, in a proper manner. I had to make a decent go of this. She had to make a decent go. That means she had to be successful. She had to be successful in participating, competing with her. Now that I had put myself into this, I may as well give it my best shot. Now there is no other option. She had put herself in it, isn't it? So this is a challenge in front of her, and what she has to do? She has to do her best. She has to give her best, perform her best. Now she can't skip, she can't run away from there, isn't it? So if she runs away, then what will happen? Everyone will consider her as a coward. So that should not happen. She should face the challenge. This is what she was thinking at this point. Okay, let me wind it up to here, and we'll continue the class in the next session. Till then, thank you very much.